Like I said, today we're going to go through some different print marketing that you can do in Command. So we're going to do most of this in the design section. So if you're on the left-hand side here, you'll just click on designs. So if you're not familiar with Command and designs, this is what the first page of designs looks like. It will give you a view of the different designs you have made. So if you don't see anything here, don't panic. If you haven't created anything in designs, there won't be anything here. So this is just showing me what I've created. So I'm going to go ahead and just click create design up here. And today we're going to choose print. And we'll continue. So before I dive into making things, I'm just going to go to this assets tab up here because I want to point a couple of things out that will make your life a lot easier. So the first thing about the assets, this is something that you can come in and fill out and upload things that you want to use on your designs over and over. This gives you a really easy way for all of your designs to be very consistent. So if you have things going on social media and then you have some print marketing, everything can be very consistent. So what I would like to do is add a color palette first. So this is if you have specific branding for your real estate business, you may want to create your color palette here so you can always pull from these colors and everything will always be the same. So I'm going to click on new color palette first, and then you just click the pluses to add your colors. So there's a few different ways you can do it. Most likely you're going to know the hex code, which is this code here. So you can just enter those and just add them here. So I'm just going to select a few random colors. Obviously these aren't my actual color palette, but we'll go with that. So now that I've added these, anytime I'm making a design and choosing the color of different graphics or fonts, I can always pull from these colors so everything will be the same. You can also upload your own fonts. So there are some built-in fonts with designs, but if there's specific fonts maybe you've purchased or found online that you're allowed to use, you can upload them here. So you would just download that font file and just upload it from your computer. So I'm just going to do that quickly. Get this font. You can also find web fonts. So if there's other fonts that you would like to add, if you click this button, it will search for web fonts that you're allowed to use. So it doesn't really give you a whole good look at what they look like, but you would just check off the ones that you want to add in, and you can add those as well. So just another way to customize designs a little bit more. Under images, you may want to come in and upload your headshot if that's something that you're going to want to add to your marketing materials. This just saves you from uploading it every single time you're creating something. This library will keep it on file for you. So you can organize them into folders. I do the social media for the office, so I have all of my agent photos in here sorted into different folders. But this is where you would want to upload that photo.
So Jessica, I just have a quick question. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So to upload my headshot, I just go into my photos and upload it in Command Assets?
Yeah, so you would come right into Designs and on this Assets tab and just go to Upload right here.
And then
you
it'll
pull from Google Drive or wherever you have it, Facebook, or if you just have it on your device, you can do it.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the best way. Under text, there's some different fields you can add. So I believe these all pulled from my marketing profile in Command. So that's in your settings where you can fill out all of your marketing information. This is one of the places that will pull from that. So it's pulled my bio, my email, my name, where I work, all of that kind of stuff. You can add new fields. So if you click add field on this side, really just anything that you're going to want to put on your marketing materials often. So if you want to put your Instagram link or your Facebook link, you can set that up with the link there. So then no matter what design you're doing, you can pull that information in. Just another time saver. Logos. So one thing you'll definitely want to do is come in and add the Keller Williams logos. These do not come in here by default. You do have to add them. There's a few places you can find them, one of which being the Google Drive that we have shared with all of you. So you can access them that way. You can download them to your computer and upload them here, but you can actually also get them directly from Google Drive, which is great. So I'm going to click on upload, but instead of going to my device, I'm going to click on Google Drive. I'm going to go to shared with me because I don't own that folder. And it's this KW folder here. Then I can go to KW logos, KW select logo. And I'm just going to check off all of the ones that I can. That. And we'll select and upload. And so that's going to add all of these logos right into my asset library so I can easily add them to my designs. So that's probably the easiest way to add them in because you can connect it directly to Google Drive. So next is elements. So these are just like stickers and objects that you may want to add to your designs. If you have a specific logo that you use for your real estate business that has a little icon in it, you may want to add that just as its own element. You might want to add those to your designs as well. So you can add those in this separate section here. We're not going to look at videos or files. That's not too relevant for what we're doing today. So if you come through here and set up your asset library, it's going to save you a ton of time, no matter what type of marketing you're doing in designs, whether it's social or print. This will just keep everything really, really consistent. Any questions about the asset library?
None so far.
Okay. All right, so I'm going to click on templates here. I'm just going to go back up to the top. So is there anything that you guys wanted to see in particular that we would create in here? I have some things planned out, but I'm happy to pivot if there's something specific.
Flyers.
Flyers, okay. That was the one that I chose as my first one, so that's good. So there's a ton of different things you could do flyers for. Right now, things are sort of opening up. I mean, not in the last couple of days, it's gotten a little bit bad, but hopefully soon we'll be able to do open houses again. So that's something you may want to create flyers for. So there are some open house specific designs here. And then at the top, you can filter by size. So whether you want a flyer or a door hanger, postcards, folded pamphlet type styles, I'm going to choose letter. And then there's a ton of different templates. So all of these have the same content. They just look a little bit different. So you just choose the one that you like the most. Obviously, they can be completely customized. All of the colors and fonts and everything can be changed. So I'm just going to choose this one here. So to use it, you just click use, of course, and that's going to open up the editor. Just a few things to point out. On the left-hand side here under images, you can see that my photo is here. That's because I added it to the asset library, so I don't need to upload that. Same with the text. If I go to my assets, these are all those little text boxes. Logos, same thing. So these are all here for me to use on every single design. So big time saver, like I said. For this one, because we are doing an open house, this listing is most likely already active on MLS. So one nice thing about using Command Designs versus something like Canva or another graphic design program is this actually will connect to the MLS system. We're all about the big time savers here. So this will save you a ton. So I'm going to click on KWLS down here. And I'm going to search for a listing. Let me see. We will go with...
Just curious. Because every time I edit for Higgins, for Wayne and Connie's team, I always use Canva. Is there a way for me to connect Canva to Command?
Unfortunately not. If you wanted to use your designs for like digital marketing, so ads and stuff, you would just have to download your completed file and upload it in as an image. Unfortunately, there's no way to connect them in here.
Ooh, okay, thank you.
No problem. So I click on KWLS over here and I'm just going to search for the listing that we're doing the open house at. Sometimes you do have to be more specific. Where is this? Oh, I got that wrong. All right, so we're going to do this one here. Select it. And so now I have all of the photos from the MLS system. So I can easily plug these right into this graphic. So we may want a nice photo of the outside of the house. So you can just click and drag these directly onto your design. If you want to create a new image, you can drag them right on, like I said, or you can just click the image that you want to replace. So that's this kitchen photo. And we're gonna switch it out for this house photo. So now that I have it highlighted, all I have to do is come over here and click this little replace image button. And that's gonna fill that image right in. This orientation's a little bit off. So I'm just gonna double click the photo. And now I can move it around and make sure that it's within those lines. So that's a little bit better. We may want to add some other photos. There's two more spots down here. This kitchen is quite nice. So I'm going to click there. This image. And this one here. So super easy to add your photos if the listing is active on MLS. Just saves you downloading and uploading in a few different steps. So now that we've got our photos in,
Jessica, so I noticed that the photo isn't quite within those lines. When it prints, you won't see that line, obviously, right? Or will you?
You will. So this particular design, this little box here is just decorative. The photo here, it goes right till this edge. So even this little overhang, this little gap here, that won't show, but it'll show right till the edge there, depending on the margins of what you're printing. All right, so we've got all our photos in here. Now we just want to make sure that all of the rest of the details match the property. So you can come in and just start typing them manually, but we also have the listing details from MLS. So this one here, the address is right here. So I'm just gonna highlight that. And then over here, I'm going to find the address and click the replace. And so that fills it in. Now it doesn't always match the proper formatting. So I'm just going to click in here and backspace that. I don't know why those boxes are there, but. All right, so now we need to obviously fix the date. So all you have to do to change the text is just double click in the text box. To make it a little bit easier when you highlight the text box, you can click this typewriter button and it opens just a generic text box. So you don't have to try and do it within this little square. You can do it here. So maybe it is today. Saturday. Save. And so now that's in there. For this one, for the beds and baths, you can also use these little replace buttons, but it doesn't work so well just specifically for this setup. They have all of the details in one text box. So if I was to go over here and try and switch this to 4 bathrooms, it's gonna take away my whole text box. So I'm just going to undo that, which is this button up here. So we don't want that. So I don't know why they set it up this way, but it's easier to just double click and come in here and edit the details. But the nice thing is you have all of the details here to reference. So you don't have to go back and forth to the cut sheet or anything. You can view them right here. So this is 3-bedroom, 4-bath. It is 2,218 square feet. It's listed for 445. And it was built in 2006. You'll notice the price here has USD. I have no idea why they put that there. It is $445,000 Canadian dollars. They just put the currency in there. I'm not sure why. So all of this is fixed up now. Maybe we want to change the colors of these things to match our branding. That's super easy. You just highlight what you want to change. Click on the color here. You can choose the color just right here, or because we added a palette to our asset library, I can go library colors, and then I have all my different color palettes that I've created. I'm going to keep this as red, but that's how you would access all your colors. Same with fonts. You just choose them in here. There's a ton of different fonts. That one that I added, let's see. It's not in here. Okay. We'll just choose this one. So you can customize them, make them a little more fancy if you want to. It's totally up to you. So
I like it.
Sorry, I didn't catch what you said there, Holly.
No, I said I like it.
Oh, okay. down here, again, you want to customize this so it fits the property that you have the open house for. I don't know anything about this property, so I'm just going to leave that as is. And then down here, it's just about you. So you would fill in your headshot, which is in my library. So I'm going to go back to images. Then I can click on this little picture and replace it, and then just start filling in my own info. This logo obviously isn't our logo, so we're gonna wanna switch that to the KW Select logo. So that's also super easy because I have added those to my asset library. I just have to click it. It opens up my logos on the side and click replace. So that has added that. It's usually a bit too small, so I will resize. So that's a super easy and quick way to make a flyer, particularly this one was for an open house, but there's a ton of different flyers you can do. Any questions about that particular design?
I have a question, not about the design, but on the bottom where it has the KW app.
Mm-hmm.
How come it's in US dollars? My app shows US dollars. Is that something you changed? I can change?
That's a KW issue. They're working on it. It went away for a while and then it just randomly appeared again. I didn't know if I had this.
I didn't know it was me and I had to fix the setting. Okay. That's all.
No. Yes. That shows for everyone. We've been fighting with them to get them to change it. So hopefully soon it will be fixed.
Okay. Thanks.
All right. So that is a flyer. Like I said, there's a ton of different ones that you can create. So next I'm going to do...
Oh, Jessica,
yeah.
Once you've created that, can you print it from here or do you just download it into your computer or what do?
Yes, thank you. I'm getting ahead of myself, clearly. So once you were done with this, you can download it. So you're going to go up here and click download. Because this is a flyer, we'll want to keep it as PDF for printing. You want this to be very high quality, especially if it's something you're handing out at an open house. You can choose PDF standard, but it compresses it a little bit and it won't print as nicely. So just choose PDF for printing. If there was more than one page, you can select which pages. And then just click download. See up here, it's preparing, and then it will download it to my computer. Then I can come into the office and print it or have it printed somewhere. But yeah, that's basically what you would do.
Okay.
If you don't want to print it and right now and you're just sort of making it ahead of time, you can just click done, which will save it to your designs. So now it's right here.
Okay. So you, if you want to download it to your computer, you do download. And if you want to just save it in your design folder or whatever, you would just say done and it automatically goes in there.
Yep.
And then you can download it later and print it and do all that, right?
Exactly. Yeah. So this is the one we just created. If I click on that, it's going to bring me right back in to where I can edit it. So you can still edit it after you click done. You can come back in and change anything if you need to. So that's the best way. You can rename it as well for your own organization. You just click on the name up here. I'm going to go back in. Another popular thing is door hangers, especially with COVID. It's a bit harder to actually go and speak to people. So you may want to do some door knocking and leave some door hangers behind. So that's something you can create in here. Most of these designs, so even this one has some door hangers for open houses. Basically any of these designs will have door hangers.
Okay, so now I have a question.
Sure.
So a door hanger, like, so when you print it, how do you hang it on the door? Do you have to go buy door hang print stuff?
Yeah, I know that, I think that they sell them at Staples, just blank door hangers. There is also, I have this tab open, like something like Vistaprint has door hangers where you can just upload the design that you've created and they will send you a bunch of them already made with the hole and everything. So,
Those are
pretty much the two options, short of sitting there and cutting the hole out yourself.
I know.
So, yeah, they do sell door hanger printable ones, I believe, at Staples, and then you can go through print companies. Most of them will make these as well.
Okay.
So I'm going to go down to lead generation, and home value. This was working before we started this training.
There are no templates.
Okay, I'm going to.
I've never seen that before.
Yeah. The very first design training I ever did, this happened. It's maybe a short-lived one. We're going to try it again. There we are. All right. Just needed a second, clearly. So there are some door hangers. This one's a great one. So this one is for home value. So right away, I can see there's two pages, which means it's double-sided. So you can design both sides of this door hanger. So I'm going to click on use on this one. So obviously this blank space is where the hole will be. So you don't want to put anything up here. You want to keep most of your info down near the bottom. I'm just going to move zoom out of the way. So again, it's the same thing for editing, just to change colors and fonts. You do it up here. Let's see. So maybe we want to do that. You can edit the text, of course. I'm just going to leave that as is for now. So like I said, there's two pages to this one. So to see what the backside looks like, if you click down here on pages, it's going to open this little sidebar and you can navigate between the two. So on the back, you can talk about your bio in here and all of your details. So again, I have all of this in my asset library. So if I go to text and my assets.
Jessica?
Yeah.
You said a while ago about the palette. Where could we find those colors so that we could, you know, follow those colors while doing our editing on designs?
So like the KW colors, you mean?
Yeah. I mean the palette you made a while ago. If we were going to do that, where could we locate that while doing our design so that we're sure that we're following the palette that we need?
Yeah, so in terms of the KW colors, I can send those out afterwards, the little codes that you can use. That way you can go into the assets and add them to your palette. But once you've added them to your palette, all you need to do when you're trying to change the color, when I choose this color, you're instead of doing these colors down here, you're going to just click this little drop down for library colors, and any of the palettes you've created are here. So my KW one is this main palette. So those are the KW colors that I have in here. But you can toggle back and forth between them. So that's where you would find them.
Okay, thank you.
No problem. All right, so I'm gonna leave that as is. So then you just fill in your details. Contact details. So if I want to put my email here, I can just highlight that, go to text, and I can replace the text. I do have to format it a little bit as well. Yeah, it's a little tricky sometimes to edit the text, so it is easier to click this typewriter and just do it in here. Save it. And delete that. So then you fill in your bio. You can download or put the link to download your app. So you can find that directly in the KW app. If you go to more and then share my KW app, it will generate a link. So you can fill that link in here. Again, just switch out the logo for the correct one. And that's it.
I'm trying to talk to you while I'm muted again. that small text there, I can't read it. So what does it say? Just add your bio,
this one here?
Yeah.
Yep, so that is just an example bio. It doesn't actually say much.
Oh, okay.
It's where it just tells you to put your bio in here. So,
oh, okay, right on. Okay.
My bio is very short. It's right here. So if you do have your bio in your marketing profile, it will pull into this text section. So it will show up just as one of these options and you can fill it in directly. So,
all right.
Highly recommend going into the marketing profile if you haven't already, because that would save a ton of time. So you don't have to go and find it, copy and paste, yeah. And paste it in here.
So the marketing profile in command?
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
I can show you where that is after if you'd like.
Okay. Thank you.
Perfect. All right. So in this case, we're really done unless there was anything else you wanted to add. And then you can just click download again. And you want to say, if you're paying for anything to be printed, I would get it approved by a broker first, run it by Anne or someone else on the broker team, just to make sure that there's nothing missing. There are some guidelines for what you need to have on your marketing materials. Logos need to be bigger than your name, things like that. So there's so many little things want to make sure before paying for something to be printed. With digital marketing, you can delete a post. It doesn't cost you anything, but if you go and pay $50 for all of these door hangers and then find out you can't use them, it would be a bit disappointing. So definitely run any printed designs by Anne, just to make sure that everything is on there that needs to be. Some other things might be like the Realtor logo and the MLS logo. Those are in the Google Drive as well. So all of those are available to you.
Hey, Jess.
Yeah.
How's it going?
Good. How are you?
Good. Good. Thanks so much. I appreciate this. Quick question. I've seen agents use like a just listed or like a sold, so they have something made in design where they post on Facebook and they have like a stamp sold or something written over top of the picture. Is that something that you can show us quickly now? Or is that something I can book with you? Or how would you suggest that?
So like where to find the sold graphic, you mean?
Yeah, something that can kind of like keys day or closing day. You know how they write them over top of the picture?
Yeah.
Like, is that difficult to do?
No. So there are templates for that as well in here.
Good question, Jen. I've often wondered that myself.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Yeah.
I thought it was a watermark, but I thought, how do I do that?
It's cool because you can write whatever you want on there.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so there are just sold templates. If we had chosen social, they would have showed up. So I can go back and show you those. Hopefully that will be what you're looking for. I think it is. So I'm just going to click on done on this one.
Okay, and then the last thing is on my signs, I have like this kind of, do you see what I mean? Like a lot of people have this thing.
Yeah.
Is there any, is that found like from the printer or is that found through a background somewhere in KW or do I ask for that background from somebody just to kind of use that as more of my branding?
That from Brandon, like the guy at Antimatter that Aaron uses?
The guy that makes our signs.
Okay. I'm not sure. I know it's on some of the business cards as well. I'm not sure if it's something he owns or if it's something he just found online. But I have seen.
I can ask Erin.
She might know. Yeah, she is away today, but I can double check on that.
I'll send her a quick note, Jess, just with my sign and ask if I can have that background. Ask her.
Okay, yeah.
Cool. Thanks.
So instead of print, I'm just going to choose social for a second, just so I can quickly show you. under listings, just sold. Let's see. So like there are ones like this. Is that kind of what you meant, or was it more of a specific graphic that they've put on top of it?
If you had an existing picture,
yes,
you could stamp a sold sign like going corner to corner.
Yeah, like an update. Here's an update. Boom, sold. Right.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Okay.
Let me try something.
Or you can even get back to us on that too if you want.
No, you can't. I want to know now. I'm so saucy.
Like I think a lot of people use that site Canva, but oh look, yeah. What's this?
Yes.
So there are some like this. These are just in the stock. These are the stock images that are in here. I don't know why it has a background that looks like crap.
Like it almost needs like where the background is cut out. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like there's not white behind it or something. I'm sure I can find something. Yeah. I was just kind of hoping like Canva is really amazing. I've been away from it for a long, long time, but I'd love to stay in one program.
I don't think these have transparent backgrounds. So.
That's great to know, Jess, though. And then we just have to go in. We legit have to just play with it, you know, take time out and just really kind of. Yeah,
exactly.
That's great. It's great to know there's, as long as there's workarounds.
Yes.
Yeah. Good,
right.
So is there like a suggestion box for command? But I know we here, like we have to take it to the US to get it approved or whatever. Like if we said we want similar things to, if they want us to use it, then give us some really cool stuff to work with, right?
Yeah.
Say that again, Jessica.
Like you'd want like more clip art and stuff like that, like little graphics that you can add to your designs.
Yes.
Yeah, very similar to what we just did now.
Yeah. So there are some paid ways to do it as well if you want really nice ones. There's people, even if you look on Etsy, there's people who sell digital products. Some of them are specifically for real estate too. So they've designed these graphics specifically for people like you to download and use. They are paid, but there are some free versions online as well. So I can send some of those links out. And then in terms of asking KW, there is, I believe it's ideas.kw.com where you can give suggestions. The more people who give that suggestion, the more likely it is to happen. So that's something you can definitely do as well. I'll send the link out for that too.
Jess?
Yeah.
Can I suggest something?
Mm-hmm.
This is something that I've been using with my client, Wayne and Connie. So if you guys are looking for something, for example, you have a picture or an image that you want no background, you could look on this link that I sent. It's a background remover. You just put your image, upload the image on it, and just click remove and wait for a second, and the background will automatically be transparent.
Okay. Is that free to use?
Yeah, it's free.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, Canva has
awesome.
That, Canva has that built in as well, but you have to be a paid.
Yeah, you have to be pro, like you have to pay for it. So I'm just continuously looking for something that would work for, you know, free.
Free, we like free.
Yeah, if you want to send that to me after, that would be great.
Yeah.
That's great.
The link, I sent the link on the chat box. Oh,
perfect.
So you just click on that, you just upload your picture and click remove the background and wait a sec, and there, it'll remove background in just a few seconds.
Well, that might be interesting for the stuff that we have here in command that we, like the ones that you just had sold on it, because if that could remove those, because they're usually white backgrounds.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, sometimes I save first the image from command, from designs,
yeah.
Then transfer it to this link, and then I'll just remove and then save it on my computer and then just upload it, and it's completely transparent.
Yeah.
Perfect. Oh, wow.
Thanks for sharing. That's wicked.
Yeah, that is awesome.
Thank you. Welcome.
All right. So I'm just going to go back now. I do just want to point out a couple of other things. I won't go into that them too deeply, but I just want to show you that they're available. So there are some listing presentations in here. There are like 30 something pages you can choose from. I'm actually going to go into this. I know I said I'm not going to, but the big PDF documents are a little bit different to navigate. So I just want to point this out. So this is a listing presentation. If I click on templates over here, these are all of the pages that I can add to my listing presentation. I've already created this one, so it has all the pages added, but they're all of the presentations are the same, just different appearance, but it goes through all different types of pages. So the process, marketing plan, finding a buyer, all about the promotional assets. So what Command offers, all of that kind of stuff. So this is something where you can just come through and click the plus button anytime you want to add that page to your listing presentation. And then once you've added all of the pages that you want to include, you just click on pages down here, and then it will go through your whole booklet. So you can go page by page and customize it. Again, the editor is the same as the graphics that we were just doing. There is this instructions page as well. So it explains how to create this listing presentation, but then it goes through all of the pages. So you can customize it for that particular client, or you can make it generic. If you want just the same presentation for everyone, you would just delete this page or not add it.
I think if I gave anybody a 30-page presentation, they'd probably boot me out after 15 pages.
Yeah, I think they'd be sleeping hard.
Their eyes would be glazing over, and
so yeah. Would mine. So would mine. Yeah, I do. Exactly.
Yeah, that's why it's set up so you can customize exactly what pages you've added.
That's great.
You can pick just the ones that you want. If you want a page about all your awards, you can do that.
Yeah, let's do that, Holly.
Info about the app and all of that. So these are in here for you. There's listing and buyer. So the buyer one will have a bit different content, obviously. But they're very easy to customize specifically for your branding, especially if you've done the asset library. There's some other ones in here. So there's local expert. So this is if you wanted to maybe do postcards about that particular neighborhood and go drop them in some mailboxes. These are great for that. You would just need to go to Paragon and get the stats and then just come in here and fill them in. And then you can get them printed wherever you would like. Let me see what else is under here. Again, there's buyer presentations. There is magazines. So these are relatively new. They've started, they're similar to the listing presentation, but more just about real estate in general. So they haven't done a fall one yet. They have summer in here, but again, there's a ton of pages in there. You can customize them to be Halifax specific or wherever you're working out of. And that's something that you can distribute to people as well.
Distribute where, sorry?
Yeah. You can send out to people, I mean, through PDF, email, or you can
put okay, right on, yeah, okay.
And have them even come in and bind them in the office, totally up to you. Under business basics, there's some other things. So there are business cards. If you wanted to up your business cards, you can come in here. So of course our design provider does have a bunch of templates, but he also will just print whatever you've created if you have created them. So these are great templates as well. They're all very KW specific and a little bit more modern. So those are great. There's some letterheads in here if you ever need them. Anything else down here? Just want to make sure. There are like event invitations. So once we're allowed to have events again, you could create those in here. Holiday greetings, there are some cards. So postcards for the holidays, if that's something you wanted to send out. There was also just blank cards somewhere in here. Oh, well, you guys can look through them. I won't spend too much time on that, but there's a ton in here. So pretty much every design has a postcard or door hanger. You can just click up here to change what that design looks like. So there's a ton like that. Any questions about the print marketing side of things before I go into the marketing profile?
Can we also make from scratch from these greetings like cards
yeah.
design?
So let me go. So I'm just going to click on my designs up here, which is another place to see everything you've created. But you can just click start from blank. And that will start just a blank canvas, and you can use all of the elements built into the editor. So if you go to images or elements, you can just start from scratch that way. Again, you can still connect to the MLS and pull photos in. That doesn't change. It just doesn't put anything on the canvas when you open it. So that would be the best way. Another thing, you can import PDF files. So if maybe you created your listing presentation in Canva, this is something you can import into designs, and you can edit it in designs. Any PDF you put in here, you can actually change the text and the colors and all of that stuff.
Ooh, I like that.
Yeah, so if it's, I mean, don't steal anyone's presentation, but if you found it online that you really liked, like the format of it, you could download it and import it here and then just change it for your branding and customize the text. It makes PDFs fully editable, even if you didn't create it in designs.
That's really cool for teams, or if you're sharing amongst colleagues or things like that. I love, sure. That's a great, I didn't even know that existed. That's
neither
awesome.
Did I.
Yeah.
And
great.
There is people who, like if you look on Etsy, or there's something called Creative Market, there are like freelancers who will create templates exactly like what's in here, just different, yeah. more, and not saying more modern, but all different styles, right? So if you found one that you really liked, you may get a PDF of it. You can import it in here and edit it through designs instead of Canva or wherever they're designating that you have to do it in. So this gives you a little bit of
Jessica, flexibility. Okay. You know that open house font that you used for your design?
Yeah.
I like it. Do you know what it's called off the top of your head?
I just chose a random one. It is Allison Script.
Yeah.
Allison Script.
That is a nice font, actually.
I like it.
Yeah, Canva, or sorry, wow, Designs has a lot of really nice fonts. All right. So the marketing profile, like I was saying, is really important for this if you want to save yourself some time. And if putting your headshot and your bio and things like that, if those are things you want to put on your marketing materials, this will make your life much, much easier. So when you're in command, you just click on your name in the top right, and then click settings. And then it's under connect settings and then marketing profile. So you can upload your headshot here. If you're on a team, upload your team logo and then just fill in all of your info. So your name, job title. So you put realtor here, your bio. There is this new realtor affiliation section, or sorry, military affiliation, if you wanted to specify that. Mobile, website, email, Market Center logo. So you do have to upload this. You download it from Google Drive and put it in here. The legal footer, which is that each office is independently owned and operated. And you can link your social profiles as well. So this is just somewhere where you can do it once, and it's gonna pull into multiple places in command, designs being one, campaigns is another. So if you're running Facebook ads, and the most important one is your website. So if you create your website through command, it will pull this information in for you as well. So do it once and never have to enter it again.